Hi, my name is Guy, and this is my friend Belt. Cook, conversationalist, navigator. Also, he keeps my pants up. He's kind of amazing, isn't he? And I bet you're wondering how he became all of those things. Okay, well, maybe you weren't wondering, but I bet you are now. Here, let me tell you. Nope. Better yet, I'll let Belt show you. Here, look. I call it Belt's Cave Journal.
Ta-da!
This is where Belt writes and draws the things we discover on our adventures, the things that happened before today. It's how we capture our stories and share them with friends like you. One day, while we were out exploring, we heard a noise, like a bird call. And it sounded scared. Belt called back, copying the sound as best he could. He was really good at it. A natural animal conversationalist. The call got louder, and Belt tracked the sound to a great big bush. The bush shook, and Belt and I got ready to run until the leaves parted and something crept toward us. He was small and fuzzy and kind of cute, tumbling toward us as he walked, flipping head over tail, wings and giant ears flapping. We named him Jackrobat in honor of Jackrobat Day, the day we met, well, Jackrobat. But as soon as he saw us, Jack leapt back into the bush to hide, and there he stayed until Belt made lunch. Belt always makes lunch, and breakfast, and dinner, and snacks, dessert too. He likes to make the food. I like to eat the food. It's a mutually beneficial partnership. Jack couldn't resist the smell of Belt's veggie juice super slurp, as I like to call it. After we ate, and after we watched Jack eat the rest of the soup all by himself, we thought Jack would leave, but he didn't. He just followed us around all day, stopping sometimes to call out like he was looking for someone, like he was calling out for his family. Jack was lost. Belt and I decided we'd help Jack find his family. Things didn't start out so well, though. We'd hardly begun our search when we were attacked by a pack of punching punch monkeys. We quickly formed a plan. We ran. But didn't get very far before we realized Jack hadn't followed us. We had to go back and rescue him. Belt and I were ready for action with our new headwear helmets. But when we returned to the monkeys, we realized Jack had already taken off. Also, important safety tip, punching punch monkeys can punch any part of the body, not just heads. Also, ow! We dashed out of there as fast as we could and got back on Jack's trail. Belt used his extraordinary navigating skills and led us out to the flat, kind of boring and ordinary area we call the plains because they're, plain. And that's where we found Jack. Being chased by a stampede of girelephants. Suddenly, Belt was digging around in the brush for something. He vanished down a hole and came out with two mousefants. Running after the stampede, we used the mousefants' loud nose blast to scatter the stampeding herd and save Jack from getting stomped. Turns out, those giant girelephants were scared of tiny mousefants. Over the course of the next few days, we discovered all sorts of new friends. We met flower frogs, they smelled lovely, and could jump almost two guys in the air. We saw a sharkodile, who saw us back, and that was bad, so we ran away, and that was better. Then we hopped on a log and floated down the river, where we caught glimpses of ponies, mega bunnies, dog with a funny bark that I called Labragoose. Floating down the river, Jack was clearly sad and discouraged. We'd come so far, Belt navigating us across the plains, through the forests, and over great rocks, but still, no sign of Jack's family. He called out one more time, then closed his eyes and curled into a little ball. Suddenly, there was a sound from the shoreline. A Jackrobat call! Jack perked up and called back. More Jackrobats appeared, flying and spinning along the shore, following us down the river. Jack cooed and flew in circles. It was his family! And that was when the river took a turn for the worse. The water sped up and the log began to spin. We were headed for a waterfall, which I like to call bad news. Belt and I were trapped. Jack flew quickly to his family, then circled back to us. Belt and Jack called to one another. They were making a plan. Belt grabbed my waist. Jack grabbed Belt, and Jack's family grabbed Jack. And just as the log went over the bad news, Jack and his family flapped their wings and flew us to safety. Once we were safe back on shore, Jack and the Jackrabats tumbled and flipped and flew around us. Belt made soup, which they loved, and Jackrabats called up into the night. Belt and I joining in their song. Their family was reunited at last. All thanks to my friend Belt, cook, conversationalist, and navigator. And there you have it. How Belt became the animal of many talents he is today, and how we made a new friend in a Jackrabat. To this day, still one of my favorite stories. I'm glad Belt keeps track of these journeys. It's fun to look back and remember all of the things that we've done together, what I call memories. And you know what? You could do it too. Make pictures of your own stories, your own memories, just like Belt. Just one last important safety tip, though. Try and make them on something a little easier to carry.
Come on.